been such a day in old L.A. But it's December the 24th, and I'm longing to be up north so I can have my very own white Christmas. Oh, yeah, I'm dreaming of a white Christmas with every Christmas card I write. May your days be merry and bright, and may all your
this is my winter song to you. The storm is coming soon. It rolls in from the sea. My voice a beacon in the night. My words will be a light to carry you to me. Is love alive? Is love alive? Is love alive? They say that things just cannot grow beneath the winter snow, or so I have been told. They say we're buried far, just like a distant star. I simply cannot hold. Is love alive? Is love alive? Is love?
Like the frost on a rose, winter comes for us all. Oh, how nature acquaints us with the nature of patience. Like a seed in the snow, I've been buried to grow. For your promise is loyal, from sea to sequoia. I know, though the winter is long, even richer than the harvest it brings. Though my waiting prolongs, even greater your promise. Lord, I think of your love like the low winter sun, and as I gaze, I am blinded in the light of your brightness, and like a fire to the snow, I'm renewed in your warmth. Of this wild soul till the barren is beautiful. And I know, and though the winter is long, even richer the harvest it brings. Good morning. How we doing this morning? Okay. Come on, how we doing this morning, church? Come on, let's stand. Let's get excited. We are in the house of the Lord. It is good to be gathered with you. I want to open with a scripture. Psalm 63, it says this, verse 2. I have seen you in the sanctuary and beheld your power and glory. Because your love is better than life, my lips will glorify you. I will praise you as long as I live, and your name I will lift. I will lift up my hands. I will be fully satisfied. My lips will sing your praise. Come on, somebody. Hey, we are excited to be in the house of the Lord. We are believing for great things this morning. As you can see, we have a baptism plan. Come on, we have a baptism plan. We got 5 people being baptized this morning. But before we start, why don't we welcome a few people? So if you're comfortable, why don't you go say hi to somebody? We are a family. It is so good to gather. South Campus, why don't you do the same? We see you this morning. Why don't you look around, shake a few hands? We do want to give a special welcome to our South Campus. Though I can't physically see you at the moment, we're so excited to partner today and to share in this service together as one church at 2 campuses. How many are ready to worship this morning? Okay, so at the north, we're ready. South, can I hear something at the south? Come on. Oh, he's worthy of our praise. Who breaks the power of sin and darkness? Whose love is mighty? It's so much stronger. The King of glory, the King above all kings. Who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder? Who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder? The King of glory, the King above all kings. Let's declare. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. Oh, you laid down your life that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. All you've done. Who brings our chaos back into order? Who makes the orphans a son and daughter? The King of glory, the King of glory. Who brings the nation into the justice? Shines like the sun in the morning. All of its brilliance, the King of glory, the King above all kings. Let's declare this is amazing grace. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love that you would take my place, that you would bear my cross. Oh, you laid down your life that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Oh, come on, let's declare worthy. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain.
Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy, worthy, worthy. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. Oh, you laid down your life. That I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. All you've done for me. Come on, let's give a praise. Hallelujah. Bless you, Jesus. Worthy are you, Lord. Oh, let's declare, angels we have heard on high. Angels we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains, and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strains. Gloria in excelsis Deo. Inspire your heavenly song. Gloria in excelsis Deo. Gloria in excelsis Deo. Come to Bethlehem and see Christ, whose birth the angels sing. Come adore on bended knee Christ the Lord, the newborn King. Gloria in excelsis Deo. Come ye, O come ye to bed. Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of ages. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Sing choirs of angels, sing in exaltation. Oh, sing all ye bright hosts of heaven above. Glory to God, oh, glory in the highest. Oh, come, let us adore. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Oh, come, let us adore. Oh, come, let us adore. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. We praise you, Jesus. We bless your mighty name, God. Glorify you, Jesus. Lord, we just focus in this morning. God, as we sing these songs, God, we declare that you are near. We focus in on you this morning, Lord. We give thanks for you, Father. Praise you, Jesus.
Generous. the Son of God hung on a cross to die.
Exalt you, Jesus. You are so worthy, Father. You are so faithful, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. God, we thank you that we can come this morning and we can just worship unto you, Jesus. We can just declare these things, and Lord, we know that they are truth. God, you are such an awesome God. Even in the midst of circumstances, Lord, we can read the scripture. We can be encouraged that you are an awesome God. You are at work, Jesus. Lord, this morning we fix our attention on some of our friends that are going through things. Lord, we think of Dick this morning. Come on, church, let's just lift up some praise to God and let's pray for him this morning. God, we pray for healing. We pray for restoration of the body. Pray for strength and endurance. Meet him, Lord. We know you are. God, we think of others that are going through. We think of Pastor Terry and what she's walking through in her family. And Lord, we pray. God, we pray for our dear sister, our pastor. Lord, comfort and strength. Would you be with them, Lord? There's so many others. We think of Una, Lord, and God, we pray that you would touch her body. Lord, that a miraculous work of your Holy Spirit would take place in her body. And God, that you would heal her. God, that you would heal her, Lord. Jesus. thank you for your goodness, Lord. We thank you, God, that we can gather together as a body, Lord, that we can have our children in here and that we can experience baptism together. Lord, I pray that your spirit would be working and that we would be, Father, that we would be attentive. Lord, we know that you're working, but we would be attentive. God, that we would pay attention to what you're doing. God, that you would stir and spur and encourage us on. And we pray these things in your name, Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. You may be seated. Church, I'm going to call the ushers forward and Cam's going to come up. We have Cam live in house to do some announcements this morning. Before that, we just want to make you aware that Martha Presbush has passed away, and there will be a memorial service at Wall and Custon's funeral home. It will be on Wednesday, December 7th. At 11 a.m. And so if you knew Martha, you've been journeying and praying for her and the family, we just thank you so much. And so again, that'll be this Wednesday at 11 a.m. And certainly if you could keep the family and friends in prayer, that would be great. We just want to pray as we receive the offering. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for your goodness, your might. Lord, we thank you, God, that you are just, you're in this place. God, it is undeniable. We sent your spirit. And Lord, I pray that as we give back to you, God, that you would bless it. Lord, you'd multiply it. And we pray these things in your name, Jesus. Amen. Go for it, bud.
Will do, will do. Okay, guys, give it up for the worship team. They did great. Yes. Wonderful, wonderful. Well, welcome, Parkview Church, both the North and the South Campus. Hey, everybody online. Nice to see you. Well, here at Parkview, you know our motto, our mission. It is we connect God to who? Does anybody know? What's the first one? You shut it out. Connect people to God, each other, and the world. That's right. That is our motto. That is our mission. And in the seat pocket in front of you, as well as online, we have what's called a connection card. Everybody say connection card. Connection card. We would love it if you could fill that out. If you are new with us, we want to get to know you, get to know your name, your story a little bit, and get connected with you. Maybe take you out for a coffee. And if you fill out that connection card and bring it back to us, you get a free gift. Everybody say free gift. Free gift. I love free things, especially it's Christmas time around the corner, so, you know, free gifts all around. anyways, I'm going to kick off today with a little joke. Everybody remembers my joke from last week, and I'm going to say a little few ones throughout the announcement. So, here we go. Okay, this is how it goes. This is how it goes. I came up with this one. I'm actually really proud of it. Don't make me laugh. Mrs. Claus caught Santa dancing in the snow. When she asked, "Why are you dancing?" Do you know what he told her? "Honey, dear, Christmas is a clause for celebration." Get it? Because cause and clause. All right. Watch this transition. Speaking of Christmas, we have the Christmas gala December 11th. Everybody say December 11th. December 11th. Oh, it's funny. My partner in crime, she's in here. Last week, she told me when I got everybody to repeat after me, it reminded her of being in VBS. So if you're getting that feeling, I'm reliving my glory days. Just let me do it. Play along. It's fun. Anyways, $5 per person or $20 per family. Sign up in the foyer or email the church, Parkview Church. info@parkviewchurch.ca. Wow, almost didn't pass the quiz there. We got dessert. In recent years, we've had like cheesecake, chocolate cake. Does anybody like chocolate cake?
I do.
Okay, vanilla lovers in here, where are you? Yes, I see you. Stay strong. Okay, stay strong. I'm so glad there's more. We have John and Sarah Slater. They'll be coming in to perform our live Christmas music. Hopefully, they're taking song requests. I'm a huge fan of Santa Baby. Anybody? Yeah? No? Just me? Okay. Just me. You love it too, Mitch. Just admit it. In any case, we also have a photo booth, which means we are doing it's semi-formal. It's going to be an onslaught of Santa Claus ties. Let's be honest. Everybody has one in here. At least every dad in here has a Santa Claus tie. Bring it. It's going to be awesome. In any case, we're going to move on to the next announcement. But before that, another joke. Who is Santa's favorite cartoon character? Chimney Cricket. Get it? Because Jiminy and Chimney, all right. That was funny. There's no, like, oh, by the way, with that joke, there's no, like, smooth transition. It's just, I thought it was too funny to pass up. I didn't come up with that. Gingerbread competition, that is coming up really soon, December 6th at 6:30 p.m. Everybody say December 6th. Everybody say December 6th. That is right. December 6th at 6:30 p.m. Sign up in the foyer for that. You know, it's funny. Foyer. Maybe you're, you know, one of the weird ones like me. I like to say lobby. That's okay. This is a great opportunity, by the way, to invite someone out to church. But here we love to build relationships in the most fun ways and honestly in the most delicious ways, it seems. Starting to notice a pattern here with dessert and gingerbread houses. Oh, man, I love sugar. Invite your friends out, especially you kids. Seriously, Trey's family, I know you got friends who got friends. Bring them, okay? Bring them. That's a challenge. That's a challenge to all of you. Bring someone. Invite someone out. And to close off today, what did Santa's elves say when they finished wrapping the presents? Oh, Tara's got it. Yeah, that's right. Well, like these announcements, that's a wrap. Parkview, welcome home.
Thank you so much, Cam. I mean, how do you follow that? I mean, oh, Cam, we're blessed to have you minister among us. Today's a special day. I thought it was important that we invite the whole church family together. If you hear a little one cry or scream beside you, that's a good thing. Don't be distracted, because we want to see our kids raised up in strength, and we want them to know what baptism is. We want them to ask mom and dad, what does that mean? And you know what? They're going to be encouraged and catch something today. So if we hear a few little rustlings, and if moms, you need to go out, there is no condemnation. You go and do what you need to do. In fact, dads, why don't you volunteer once, just to be kind, just, yeah, anyways. It's a good day. Man, the presence of God is here today. How many sense his presence in a special way? You know, and his name is, you know, we've been looking at Isaiah, and Mark 1 declares this. Mark 1:1 says, the beginning of the good news about Jesus the Messiah, the Son of God. His name is the Son of God. And everything about that changes everything. Turn neighbor and say, Son of God. Son of God. That's one of the names of Jesus. And his name is the Son of God. It was really interesting that when the Gospel of Mark was written, if you looked at coins, they would have inscriptions on them, just like we do. I mean, we're going to do a little quiz here. What is written? It's funny because I know what is written on American coins, in God we trust, right? But I don't know what is written on a Canadian coin. Perhaps you do. But maybe some of you know. What is a dime? Callum? A dime is 10 cents. And what does it have, Peggy? It's got a blue nose. Do we still have nickels? What's on a nickel? A beaver's on a nickel. What's on a loony? What's on a loony? And what's on a toonie? What's on a toonie? A bear is on a toonie. How many of you like toonies better than nickels? All the kids are saying, amen, Christmas is coming. But it's interesting because on the coins, when this gospel was written, there was a coin with an emperor on it. And it said, Divani Filius, Son of God. So right away, as soon as people would have been reading this scripture, they are saying it is not the son of the emperor. It is not a Roman emperor that is the Son of God. But Jesus Christ, the Messiah, is the Son of God. And he's putting the whole world on notice that there is only one Son of God, and his name is Jesus. And this Jesus, this salvation story that sometimes we think begins at the Nativity, began way back in the Garden of Eden, right back in Genesis. Jesus has his first promises in Genesis chapter 3. And we were reminded of God's salvation history that was true not just to Adam and Eve, but to the people of God of Israel. And Mark chapter 1, verse 2 says, as it is written in Isaiah the prophet, I will send my messenger ahead of you who will prepare your way, a voice of one calling in the wilderness, prepare the way for the Lord, make straight paths for him. And so John the Baptist appeared in the wilderness, preaching a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. The whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem went out to him, confessing their sins. They were baptized by him in the Jordan River. John wore clothing made of camel's hair with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. And this was his message: after me comes the one more powerful than I, the straps of whose sandals I am not worthy to stoop down and untie. I baptize you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. John knew who the Son of God really was. And John preached something called repentance and turning around. And you know what? Repentance is sometimes something that we're reluctant to do. How many of you like to confess something you did wrong, kids, to mom and dad? No, they all have really big eyes saying, I would never want to do that. You know what? The older you get, our nature doesn't change much, doesn't it? Reluctance to being repentant is sometimes something that we all struggle with. But for those of us that know the Son of God today, there's nothing more beautiful than the gift of repentance. There's nothing more beautiful than confessing that Jesus has changed my life, because repentance gives us the opportunity for a new beginning. We're able to leave that old personal history behind. And as we know his name, the Son of God, he brings us into new and everlasting life. And sometimes we have to wait, just as John the Baptist in Israel waited a long time. Sometimes waiting can be really hard. Last week was the first Sunday of Advent, and we talked about that hopeful expectation. But, you know, when we wait for something, it takes an act of humility that reminds us of repentance. Sometimes it's really hard to wait to open the Christmas gifts, kids, below the Christmas tree, isn't it? I won't share a story, but one time, Caden, when I was a little bit older than you, I tried to open a gift and then rewrap it. It didn't work out well. Don't try it. But sometimes we recognize, too, that we can be reluctant to repent. But sometimes as we humble ourselves and repent and say, God, I'm in need of you as the Son of God, there is nothing more beautiful, there's nothing more life-giving than repenting of our sins and saying, Jesus, I need you. I need the power of your cross, only that which you can provide. And to confess him not only as our Savior, but to confess him as Lord, as the Son of God. Is he your Lord today? Sometimes within our own hearts, we can be reluctant, but I'm thankful that today we have people that move beyond reluctance and repented and have confessed Jesus as Lord and Savior. And just like 2,000 years ago, when people came to be baptized by John, who pointed to Jesus, they are being baptized in the name of Jesus, in the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost today. You are going to hear stories of changed lives. You're going to hear stories that have moved beyond reluctance and into repentance and confession in the Son of God, the Son of the living God. His name is Jesus. So I want to encourage you today, just very quickly, as you reflect upon Jesus, as we wait for him to come a second time into a world, may we push beyond the reluctance that we can sometimes do to repent or to humble ourselves, but say, God, here am I. I need you. Do something new in me. So we're going to start to hear some of those stories today of the Son of God that is alive and active in people's lives. I want to invite Jamie Mountain to come on up. Let's give him a good hand today. Invite Pastor Tamara and the family just to come and stand with him today. And these are special moments. Because Jesus said in Matthew 28, therefore go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. This is a very special time for you today, Jamie. I know that sometimes looking out to a crowd like this might not be your natural comfort zone, but he's taking a step of faith today. And we honor that faith in you, Jamie. So, Jamie, do you love Jesus today?
I do.
You do? Praise God. And, Jamie, why don't you tell us a little bit of your journey today?
Well, I grew up in a Christian family. I knew all the Bible stories growing up. I had a very loving mom and dad all the way through. I lost my mom to cancer when I was 16, so that was a tough time, but Jesus always showed his love to me, his grace, that I always felt his presence, even when, you know, you saw her suffering, and especially in her later stages, and how tough a disease that is. Then in college, you know, fell a little away from him, but he was always there. His voice was always calling me back. He always showed his love to me, and even when I was up north in Fort Frances, I could still feel it. So when I moved back home, I decided to kind of rededicate my life to him, serving him in any way I could, and eventually it led me to Guelph, it led me to my wife Tamara, and life has been really good ever since.
Wow. Jamie, hearing that story, and because when we hear one another's stories, we're reminded that Jesus is faithful. Jesus has been so faithful to you. His hand is on you. And Jamie, we're honored today to hear you share that story. Isn't it encouraging to hear stories today and stories of life change? Jamie, we honor your faith. And your wife is going to baptize you in a few moments. This is going to be amazing. But as a church family, we want to come alongside of you. And because when we come to know Jesus, we truly believe that our best days are yet ahead. We believe in the calling and the gifting of God on your life. We are thankful that he's placed you in the city. We are so thankful for your presence and the man that you are. And we want to stand with you in these days ahead in Jesus' name. Jamie, we love you today. And we, church family, we want to pray a prayer of blessing over Jamie before he goes to the waters of baptism. I'm going to ask Pastor Tamara's mom. Her name's Pastor Wendy. She's a pastor in Paris, Ontario. Can we welcome her to the house today? And let's be family today. So if you feel a little conservative, shake it out of you right now. And just as Pastor Wendy begins to declare and pray, could you stretch forth your hands right now? We're going to bless Jamie in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Jamie, during worship, I just was praying and asking God what to speak over you. And I felt God say to pray over you the faith of Noah, that you will walk in that faith that is not seen, but only felt and heard by the name of the Lord. I felt that I'm supposed to declare over you a love as David loved God, an integrity as David loved. I feel that I'm to call upon you wisdom of Solomon, that you will walk in the wisdom that God will bestow upon you, a boldness as Paul had, that you will walk in places that God has called you to walk, and you will walk in boldness and knowing, and you will have the words that the Holy Spirit will give to you. And lastly, I feel that I'm supposed to call upon you, warrior, as Gideon. Gideon didn't see it in himself, but God saw something in him that nobody else saw, that he didn't even feel himself. And I feel today that God wants to call upon Gideon, warrior, to you. That you will walk in boldness, that you will fight a good fight, that you will be the man that God has called you to be. And you will walk in the confidence in who you are in Jesus Christ. So God, we thank you for his declaration today that he wants to serve you with all of his heart. Father, we pray that you will go behind him, before him, around him, protect him. And Lord God, may he always sense your spirit upon him. We thank you for his life. We thank you for his decision today. And we honor you, Lord God, in Jesus' precious name, amen.
Jamie, we're proud of you. Now, if you want to kindly step into that nice, warm, baptismal tank, and your wife, Pastor Tamara, is going to lead you through this moment.
Thank you. willing to serve Jesus as Lord and Savior. And today, in front of everybody here, are you committing to serve God for the rest of your life? I do.
Jamie, we're going to help you out of the tub. We believe that confession that you've just made is life-changing. You're going to rise up in those declarations that Wendy spoke over your life. Today's a new day for you in Jesus' name. Let's give him a good clap offering today and celebrate with him. Amen, amen, amen. Amen. We're going to invite Mr. Greg Pappas. Come on up, Greg. And if Greg has friends or family, you are most welcome to join Greg today. Amen. Amen. Jamie, you're a nice, tidy person. Don't worry about getting wet. Got a nice little carpet there. There we go. There we go. Greg, come on up and just watch the water there. Actually, maybe we'll just stand right here just so there's no one slip. We don't want anyone to slip. We don't want a healing service today, although we love healing. Greg, it's wonderful to have you and family and friends join with you today. You're not alone. You've got the wonderful support of friends and family, but we'd love to hear your journey of what Jesus has been doing in your life in this season.
All right. Sorry, I went a bit overboard, but so getting here has been difficult. I'd like to say I've been a Christian for most of my life. I was privileged to grow up in a Christian home and attend church regularly with my amazing family. Even though I was immersed around those of faith and had such amazing role models to look up to, I've always been hesitant to get baptized and ultimately give my life fully to Christ. There are a few reasons why, but I think it mainly comes down to the burdens I've carried. Burdens of sin, depression, loneliness, and feeling as though I don't belong. Feeling as though I haven't been enough and never would be enough, not only for my family and friends, but ultimately for God. That because of the things I've done and how I've treated others and myself, I wasn't worthy of anyone's love, especially God's. I do struggle with these thoughts sometimes, but by God's grace, when I think about where I was 2 years ago compared to today, I'm just amazed at the things God has done in my life. Amen. Almost 2 years ago, I started attending Parkview Church with my brother. It was a big move for me. I'm not good with change, but I knew it was time. I knew I couldn't continue living my life for myself and by myself, allowing the burdens I carried to continue to chain me down. Since I started attending Parkview, I've been blessed to find a community of believers that truly care about one another, love one another, and find as many opportunities as possible to get to know others. Believers that step out of their comfort zone and get to know new attendees and find ways to get them involved. Because God led me to Parkview, I have now found a place I truly feel as though I belong, in this beautiful community of believers, a part of God's family. Family that has given me the opportunity to grow closer in my relationship with Christ and learn to truly trust and rely on him for everything in my life. I'm going to embarrass my sister a bit and my nephew, but there's one more thing I need to mention that has also impacted my life for the last couple of years. In early 2020, shortly after the pandemic began, my nephew was diagnosed with leukemia. After 2 years of treatment, including chemo and two bone marrow transplants, he has been healed by God. Praise God. Over those 2 years, I witnessed miracle after miracle, but what stood out to me the most throughout it all was my sister, my nephew's mom, and the amazing faith and strength she showed through it all. was nothing short of miraculous. When I think back through it all, and even today, I'm amazed at the experience, how the experience has transformed my sister. I can't imagine being in her shoes, but she was able to pull through and was a beacon of strength not only for her son, but also for those around her. I didn't think it was possible to see so much love, faith, and strength through something like this, but we did because of Christ. This has really stuck with me. If my sister and her family could go through something like this, come out stronger and closer to God than what was holding me back, why was I letting the struggles and doubt I faced hold me back when God has already been there, waiting and wanting to carry us through and make us stronger and more like him because of it, when he is there to help carry our burdens and release us from the chains of our sins? There are so many other amazing people and events that I can mention that have had a significant impact on my life and led me here today. But ultimately, it all comes down to Christ. Through Christ, I have found a place where I belong, in his family, a part of God's family. Amen. Through Christ, I can battle and push through when the enemy tells me I'm not enough. Through Christ, I can release my shame, guilt, and failure of the past. Amen. Through Christ, I have been forgiven, and through Christ, I have hope for the future. I'm so thankful we worship a living God, a God that is alive and with us, a loving God that left the splendor and glory of heaven to live among us and paid for our sins through his shed blood on the cross, so that we would no longer be separated from him, that no matter my past or what your past looks like, he has already paid for our sins, our debt. We all have an amazing opportunity to start our lives fresh in Christ because of his sacrifice. Today, I'm so thankful I can get baptized in an amazing way to acknowledge this sacrifice and show my love for him publicly, and all while being surrounded by so many people that I love dearly and that have played a huge part in helping me get here. Praise God.
Wow. Amen. Well, before we step in, this family that loves you so dearly, could you guys come around and lay hands on them today? We want to take these moments. We don't want to rush baptism. We don't want to rush what God's doing in people's lives, do we?
No.
We thank God. Father, would you, church family, would you stretch forth your hands? Father, we thank you for this man. We thank you for a new beginning. We thank you, Lord, that you've loved him with a faithful and everlasting love. We thank you for the man that he knows he is in Christ. He's a new man with a new future, a new beginning. We declare that over Greg today. We thank you for him today. We thank you for the man and the blessing that he is in this house. And we thank you that he's met with you. We thank you, Lord, that he knows you personally as Lord and Savior, and it shines in him. We thank you that his days will become brighter with hope and great anticipation. We say those dark clouds are gone, and the clouds of abundance are coming to Greg's life. We stand with him as a natural and a spiritual family, and we praise God for the amazing grace at work and evident in his life. And thank you for new strength and new boldness and new passion and new fire. Thank you for Greg. We declare and stand with him today in Jesus' name. And all God's people said, amen. Amen. Greg, you ready to be baptized? Join Pastor Tamara.
So, Greg, do you love Lord Jesus Christ? And have you repented of your sins and chosen to serve him as Lord and Savior? And today, are you committing yourself to serving him for the rest of your life? Awesome.
Thank you. Come on, how many know God is good? God is good. God is good. We've got some youth. Do you want to call?
So next, I'm going to call up Majeta Lua, if you want to come forward. If you guys want to give her a hand of encouragement.
Invite her and her family to come up. You know what? Faith has no age. You know that when you've repented and you've come to know Jesus, that is the gift. And do you love Jesus today? Now, these people look nice, don't they? They look pretty nice. They got nice, warm smiles. They're standing with you today because they love and believe with you. You've got an amazing family standing with you today as well. And could you share a little bit of your story today with us about why you want to be baptized today?
Hi, my name is Majeta Lua, which means I belong to God. I was born into a Christian home, so all my life I've been taught about Jesus and what it means to be a follower of him. When I was pretty young, we went to my grandma's house about April 2016, and we were talking about God, and I realized that I wanted to give my life to him. And in my journey with God, I've learned to always trust in him and to always be patient with him. So I'm ready.
Those are good qualities, to trust and be patient. We could use a little bit of that anointing. Yes. And so you're ready to be baptized. Yep. And you're going to love Jesus. I'm thankful for another generation that's rising up, that knows with confidence who God is. We stand with you today. We're really excited. You know you belong to God. And you've made the decision to say, God, I want to walk with you all the days of my life. We believe that God has amazing plans for you, plans for a hope and a future. And we're excited to see how God will unravel those plans in the days ahead, in Jesus' name. Hey, you guys can come a little bit closer. Don't be on the other side of the tub. We're going to gather around you today. We want to pray a prayer of blessing over your life. And I think, Dad, did you want to pray blessing? So the family are going to lay hands on her today. Could you just stretch forward your hands to this amazing young woman? We're going to agree with the Father's blessing today, in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name. Isaiah 54 verse 13 says, our children shall be taught of the Lord, and great shall be their peace. So in front of the entire church this morning, we pray for Majeta Lua in the name of Jesus Christ. That peace that God promised, that as we are taught of the Lord, that peace will fill your heart in Jesus' name. The peace that shows that as you grow older, you remain in the center of God's plan for your life in the name of Jesus. The kingdom of peace that grants you boldness in the face of everything that you're going to face in life in the name of Jesus Christ. The kind of peace that ensures that you will always make God proud, make your family proud, and everything that you do in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. The whole church, we bless Majeta Lua. She takes this step of faith today. It's been well with her in all she does, in her spiritual life, in academics, in all the choices she will make in life, that your peace that passes all understanding will saturate everything she does. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Amen. Amen. Amen.
All right, Majeta Lua, do you love Jesus? And have you repented of your sins and are choosing to serve him as Lord and Savior? And so today, in front of everybody, are you committing to serve him for the rest of your life?
Amen, amen, amen. God is good, amen? God is good. And all the time, God is good. We are so excited. Flourish, are you ready? Flourish, come on up, young man. Come up with your family and those that are standing with you. Wow. Aren't these names amazing? There's power in every name. I belong to God. Wow, what a name. Flourish, you've got a pretty fine name as well. Family, you can come along right beside Flourish today. Flourish, do you love Jesus? You do love Jesus. Flourish, why don't you tell us a little bit about your story and testimony today?
Okay. Hi, my name is Flourish Oluwanifemi Okbawaye. And I was very lucky to live in a house of God with my parents. And ever since I was a little kid, I was always shunned away and disregarded by my peers because of my skin color. But because of God, I'm able to be brave and tell everyone about Jesus and preach about it to everyone.
We've got a preacher today. Flourish. We stand with you, and all we can say to what you declared is yes and amen. Can the house say amen to that?
Amen.
Some of you might be reminded, or some of you might feel how Flourish did, but you needed to hear his words today, that God will make you strong and courageous. And Flourish, we declare that you will do mighty exploits for the Lord your God.
Amen.
You will do mighty exploits for the Lord your God. In Jesus' name. I don't know if there's a mom or dad that wants to prophetically pray over him today. Dad's going to do it. Family, just come around and lay hands and Flourish here. And church, could you stretch forth your hands today over
Flourish? Heavenly Father, we thank you. We appreciate you for a day like this. We give you thanks because you have given Flourish unto the household of God. Mm-hmm. We thank you because, Lord, no one can have anything except is given to him from above. We appreciate you for what you have done today. Father, accept our thanks in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, I pray concerning your son, as he has declared you today. Father, he will reign with you. Even at your coming, he shall be with you in the name of Jesus. When you shall appear in glory, Flourish will not be found one day. In the name of Jesus, as you have been baptized, you are soaked into the water and you rise with Jesus.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Amen. So Flourish, do you love the Lord Jesus Christ?
I do.
And have you repented of your sins and are choosing to serve him as your Lord and Savior? And today, in front of everybody, are you committing to serve him for the rest of your life?
Gotta love Flourish. You've gotta love that his testimony was like a knockout punch to the enemy in Jesus' name. He's a heavyweight in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, amen. How many have enjoyed this day? You know, when we hear the stories of coming to know Jesus, it's this wonderful mosaic where everything is different. Every story is different because Jesus meets us in so many different ways, in so many ages and stages. and you're just not encouraged today, you're hearing how Jesus is still at work changing lives. Last but not least, Connor, why don't you come up today? Connor's our youngest candidate today, and our family's with you, buddy. We're excited. We love you. Connor's been wanting to be baptized for about 3 years. He's been waiting for this moment, haven't you? And I said, Connor, would you like to be baptized here at this church? And he said, no, Daddy, I want you to baptize me. So he's been waiting patiently, just as many did for the coming of Jesus. But Connor, you love Jesus today, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Connor, what's it like to be grade 6 and to live for Jesus?
Feels great. I share the love with in class. I share the love of God.
You do. A few weeks ago, we invited a substitute teacher to church, and I heard she came. Connor, you've grown up in a Christian home, but why don't you tell us a little bit about you? What's it like to be Connor?
I'm social. I like playing soccer. I like telling jokes. I like playing with my youngest brother.
You know what? Isn't that cool? Connor, we're so proud of you today. And we know that you love Jesus. Do you love Jesus with all of your heart?
Yep.
You do. It's very evident, isn't it? Repentance is all about faith and knowing Jesus and living for him. I think one of the greatest testimonies is that we never need to wander, and we think of these three young people that we've baptized. We're believing that in a culture that is now increasingly, as you serve God, counterculture, that they will be strong and mighty in the exploits of God. Connor, we're proud of you today. We're going to ask Pastor Tamara to pray a prayer of blessing over you today.
Church, if you would extend your hand toward Connor as the family gathers around. Jesus. Father God, we thank you so much for Connor. God, I thank you for his life and the journey that he's already been on at such a young age, God. And today he is proclaiming, he is professing in front of everybody that he loves you. So God, we thank you for that. God, I thank you for his testimony. I thank you for the journey that you have brought him on. And God, I pray from this point on, you would continue to lead and guide him, God, that you would bring him to new things, new heights, new places, God. God, I pray that Connor would be a world changer, Lord. You have amazing things in store for him. God, I pray as he continues in this journey with you, God, that you would show him those things. God, that you would be preparing him for what his future is with you. God, and even now at such a young age, he's so willing to share you with others. God, I pray he would never lose that, but that he would be a light. He would be an evangelist towards the people around him, God. God, that he would bring people to you in Jesus' name. God, we thank you for his life, for his family. We pray that you would bless him today. God, bless him in his future, Lord Jesus. Thank you for your love and your grace and your mercy that is showered upon Connor today, Lord. May this be a day, may this be a monumental moment in his life, God, that as he looks back on this day, he remembers what you did and what you're going to do. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
It was funny because I said, Connor, did you bring a change of clothes? He did, but I forgot to bring mine. Okay, buddy. All right, you can go down on your knees. There you go. Connor, do you love Jesus?
Yes.
Have you repented and confess Jesus as your Lord and Savior? If so, say, I have. And do you commit to serve the Lord Jesus Christ all the days of your life? If so, say, I will.
I will.
what an exciting day to be in church.
Amen.
It's hard to know what to do when your pants are wet. But I feel like I'm by the River Jordan. I've been to the River Jordan. This is much nicer, let me tell you. The River Jordan is just like this little brown, muddy creek. But there's something special that when we rejoice and when we thank God. Church family, can we stand to our feet today? Could you take the hand of the person beside you right now, young and old? Let's stand together as a complete church family today. Lord Jesus, we thank you for the stories that we've heard. We thank you, Lord, for Greg. We thank you for Jamie. We thank you for Magenta, Lord. We thank you for Flourish. We thank you for Connor. We thank you for the grace of God that's working in lives. We thank you, Lord, for the grace that's working in the hand that we're holding right now. Lord, may we be a people that always declare you as the Son of the living God. Thank you, Lord, that we know that your name is above every name. And Lord, we choose in these moments together, we're reminded, Lord, you did it in their lives today, but you did it in us. We thank God that, Lord, you are still working as Savior, Healer, Baptizer, and in this Advent season, we declare that you are the coming King, the Son of the living God, the God Most High. So, Lord, in this song, may it be a prayer to us today, and we lift up the name that's above every name, the glorious, the majestic, and the mighty name that is Jesus. Come on, give the Lord a clap offering. Put those hands together. Come on, my jeans are wet. You can clap today. And we're going to sing and celebrate that he's alive. Come on, team, take it away.
Wandering into the night, wanting a place to hide this weary soul, this bag of bones. I try with all my might, but I just can't win the fight. I'm slowly drifting, a vagabond. And just when I ran out the road, I met a man I didn't know. And he told me that I was not alone. Come on. You picked me up. You turned me around. You placed my feet on solid ground. I thank the Master. I thank the Savior. Because you healed my heart. You changed my name. Forever free. I'm not the same. I thank the Master. I thank the Savior. I thank God. I cannot deny what I've seen. I got no choice but to believe.
From now till I walk the streets of gold, I see.
Come on, how many are free this morning? Come on, how many are free this morning? Hallelujah. Hey, I think we had church this morning.
Yes.
You know, hey, we just want to continue to celebrate. And so we do have some mini cupcakes in the lobby. We'd love to just connect and be together as family. But before we do that, we just want to quickly pray. God, we thank you for today. Lord, we thank you for today. God, we thank you for the lives of each one. God, we thank you that we can gather together as a body. And Lord, we are free, we are alive in you, Jesus. And today we declared new life. God, we want more. God, we want more baptisms. Lord, we want more that are filled with your Holy Spirit. And so I pray, God, as we go forth, God, that we would just be calling upon your Spirit. Lord, we'd be asking, God, what's next? Lord, you're doing great things. We declare your goodness over this house. And God, as we heard from Connor, Lord, that we would be witnesses. God, that we would tell others, a substitute teacher, a friend, someone we don't know. God, would you encourage us, Lord, to share your gospel? Use us, Lord. We bless your name, Jesus. We bless his name. Amen, church. Amen. May you be blessed. Thank you.